Yeah, those last are special guests. Maybe for the benefit of the guests, I will explain a little bit the structure of today's meeting. Today we have the typical agenda of Toastmasters gathering, meaning that we will have three parts of the meeting. One part will be dedicated towards the prepared speeches. A couple of people from our club will be delivering their projects towards the audience. The second part will be, as Hala mentioned, a table topic session where the table topic master will invite us to participate in some impromptu, improvised speeches. And they will be the last, third part of the meeting, which will be dedicated to evaluation. So there will be the team of evaluators who will be giving us their perception and feedback about what happened during the meeting. My role here is the Toastmaster, and I will be leading the first and also cover the second part of the meeting. And when I was preparing towards this tonight, and it was the time where this our executive committee was changing, and there was a little bit of discussion about that, and that also made me thinking about that change, but not only in Toastmaster context, but also a little bit broader. I started thinking about that change, it's a role in our life, what does it mean, how it comes, how it goes. And I was thinking, what would be our life if there would be no changes in the life? And it was hard to imagine what is this. I realized that what is around us is a result of somewhat changes. Even we are made by the sequence of the changes happening in our life. So this means that change is something vital, which is kind of unremovable parts of our life. And because of the effect or impact the change makes to our life, it seems to be the very important element of our life. For instance, British people are saying, if you always do what you've done, you always get what you've got. Yeah? Meaning that if you want something extra, you need to do something different. At the same time, our Chinese friends, they are saying, if they want to wish something bad to someone, they say, I wish you will be living in the times of changes. That means that indeed, the change comes with some difficulties. And when we are found ourselves in the middle of some changes, well, for most of the situations, it's kind of difficult experience because we need to put some more effort, more energy, or to meet something new and get it. There's something new inside our minds. But the beauty of the change, it is rewarding, because there's always the reward at the end of the change. Even if perhaps this change in things are not so nice in the beginning. For example, in my story, about what, 15 years ago, probably I had some back problems. And these problems used to be a kind of serious ones. And I was, I think, about 6 weeks in the bed. I could not move. I even could not go outside to buy some food. And I was fully reliant on my wife to feed me and support me during that day's painful experience. Next thing, the doctors from traditional medicine, they gave up and say, Mikhail, the surgery is your way out. I didn't want the surgery. I googled up for some other methods. And finally, I ended up doing some physical exercises, which helped me to recover. And in the end, I was able to quit smoking because of that. And I think I started liking some physical activity. So after that painful period, I ended up a little bit difficult person, and hopefully a little bit more experienced and a little bit more better one. So that's why I want to dedicate this meeting towards this change topic. Okay? So that's, well, because we are here, as we say, the Toastmasters, this is where our leaders are made. This means we're really actively looking for the changes, and we are eager to work through those changes. And the skill to work with the changes include multiple components. And what one thing is common is that when you approach change, you need to approach that with a positive attitude and make it fun. And today for the meeting, we have a special person who will help to set up the mood for this meeting. This person experienced change in her life because she moved from her native city, Perm, to Moscow. And it was kind of difficult in the beginning because she didn't know anyone in the city. Everything was new. and she ended up with a lot of friends and a good job and likes the life currently. And I would like to invite to the stage Ekaterina Kalugina, who will be our joke master for the day.